Hey everyone, I'm Pete Estes. Welcome to another edition of Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. We'll start on the pitch where a pair of UVM freshmen had big weeks and were honored by the America East Conference as Rookies of the Week. Brian Wright received the honor for the second time this season after scoring twice last week in games against Dartmouth and Binghamton. Nikki McFarland picked up her first career honor following a two-goal week as well, finding the scoring touch in a 3-1 win over UMass Lowell and in a 1-1 draw with Maine. Saturday marks the start of the Bring on the World Tour for the U.S. Women's National Hockey Team, and it starts right here in Gutterson Fieldhouse. Let's hear more from the world's best as they return to Burlington.
We are looking forward to returning to Burlington. It was such an awesome atmosphere at the Gutterson Fieldhouse in 2012 Worlds, and I mean, the fans, the whole city really, the whole town walking up and down the streets, they were just fired up and embraced us having there, and so We're looking forward to it. We're excited about it. We're excited to return there.
Our team's expectations for this tour is to go into every game extremely prepared and just do the best that we can do to win every game. I mean, you know, sometimes we're going to hit bumps in the road, but it's a learning experience, and so we want to peak at the right time, which will be in February, and so hopefully the tour will prepare us for that.
The community is fantastic. They reach out to us. You're walking up and down the streets and shopping, and there's signs promoting the games, and people are looking forward to it. And so we enjoy how much they embrace our game coming. And so we thank them, and we're really excited to step on the ice in Burlington.
The America East Cross Country Championship is a little over 3 weeks away. In this week's Catamount Closeup, we get to know cross country and track and field head coach Matt Belfield.
Hi, my name is Matt Belfield. I'm the head coach for cross country and track and field for both men and women here at the University of Vermont, starting my 11th year here in Burlington. My wife had been an assistant coach here from 93 to 97 under former head coach Ed Kuziak. And when we began dating, I'd spent some time up here in Burlington. And long after we were both gone from here, my wife knew that Ed was going to be retiring. So it was a place that I'd liked. She'd loved working here. It was a good opportunity for me to advance my career in a place that we were going to be excited about raising our family as well. A gentleman by the name of Clayton Brooks, who was the head coach at the University of Redlands when I began my graduate assistantship, he was one of those guys, we had some similarities even though he was 30 years my senior, that he played football and done track and field and became a cross-country coach as a process of running the whole program. And he learned his biomechanics and kinesiology along the way, and was just a tremendous technical coach. But more importantly, he was a guy who understood the balance in people's lives and how to get the best out of them individually, and definitely my mentor for coaching. Favorite TV show is probably still the old Family Ties with Michael J. Fox, so I'm excited he's back on TV. And Spin City was great when he was on it too. So. Favorite movie? I guess I gotta go with Caddyshack. There's just way too many good lines from that movie that come in handy from time to time. Well, I don't know if it's really a snack, but certainly dark chocolate in almost any form is great. Certainly over cashews is the way to go. Favorite meal? There's a couple pasta dishes that my wife makes that are wonderful. One's a penne pasta with tomatoes and a vodka sauce, which is pretty nice. So.
We'll close out the show with the first installment of the Moe's Moment of the Week. Check out this play from Amanda Pelkey of the women's hockey team against Penn State. That's it for us today on Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. Make sure to check back next week for more great stories right here on Catamount TV.